An impenetrable defense. Separatist ships blockade the resource-rich planet of Christophsis, trapping Senator Bail Organa and his relief effort. Desperate to aid the esteemed senator, a Republic task force, under the command of Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker, must break the impasse. But time runs short for the senator and the good citizens of Christophsis. A planet under siege. Separatist forces mercilessly batter the beautiful and elegant world of Christophsis. Unable to defend themselves any longer, the people of Christophsis call on the Jedi for assistance. Hoping to save lives and prevent further destruction, Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker plan a daring ambush which could turn the tide in the fight for this crucial star system. A galaxy divided. Striking swiftly after the Battle of Geonosis, Count Dooku's droid army has seized control of the major hyperspace lanes, separating the Republic from the majority of its clone army. With few clones available, the Jedi generals cannot gain a foothold in the Outer Rim as more and more planets choose to join Dooku's separatists. While the Jedi are occupied fighting a war, no one is left to keep the peace. Chaos and crime spread, and the innocent become victims in a lawless galaxy. Crime Lord Jabba the Hutt's son has been kidnapped by a rival band of pirates. Desperate to save his son, Jabba puts out a call for help. A call the Jedi are cautious to answer. Clone troopers unite! As war rages across the galaxy, the Republic's clone army strives for victory against the evil forces of the Separatists. Bravery, valor, unity, the lifeblood of victory on the battlefield and in space. It all begins on the planet Kamino, where Jedi General Shaak Ti oversees the training of clones with the help of contracted bounty hunters. Bred to be perfect soldiers, these cadets must first be subjected to intense physical and mental training before heading off to war. A world under siege. The Separatists have launched a massive offensive against the planet Ryloth. A blockade of deadly battleships has cut off any support for the dwindling Republic defenses. Though they have fought valiantly with the help of Twi'lek freedom fighter Cham Syndulla, hope is fading for Jedi Master Dai and his men as the droid army closes in. A galaxy divided by war. Peaceful worlds must choose sides or face the threat of invasion. Republic and Separatist armies vie for the allegiance of neutral planets. Desperate to build a Republic supply base in the system of Tadaria, Jedi Master Yoda travels to secret negotiations on a remote neutral moon. The clone Starfleet is under siege. Dozens of Republic warships have been destroyed in merciless surprise attacks that leave no survivors. Rumors spread of a terrible new Separatist weapon. In the face of growing fear, the Jedi Council sends Master Plo Koon to hunt down the menace before it strikes again. A deadly weapon unleashed. The Separatist battleship Malevolence advances unopposed through Republic space, tearing apart any ship that stands in its path. After a daring rescue and narrow escape, Anakin Skywalker prepares a counterattack on the enemy ship and its diabolical droid commander, General Grievous. Grievous in retreat! Before the battleship Malevolence could destroy an Outer Rim clone medical base, a Republic strike force, under the command of Jedi General Anakin Skywalker, crippled the warship, disabling its dreaded ion cannon. Now the Jedi relentlessly pursue the Malevolence. Clone forces rally. As the war escalates in the Outer Rim, the Jedi Knights are spread thinly across the galaxy. Many new clones are rushed into service to support their Jedi generals. Unfortunately, because of the relentless demands of battle, many young clones must join the struggle before their intensive training has been completed. These clones, manning a vital network of tracking stations, are all that stand between the Republic and invasion. After suffering a series of disastrous defeats at the hands of General Grievous, the Republic's foothold in the Outer Rim is in jeopardy. Commissioned to protect the strategic world of Bothawai, Anakin Skywalker and his weary battle group are all that stands between the system and domination by the droid army. Missing in action! Anakin Skywalker's heroic droid navigator R2-D2 was lost in battle. When a desperate search fails to locate R2, Anakin is forced to take on a new navigator, R3-S6. Now the Jedi embark on a dangerous new mission to find a secret enemy listening post. Meanwhile, R2-D2 has fallen into the hands of a vile droid smuggler and is on his way to General Grievous, who will surely plunder the Republic's secrets hidden within him. The Clone War threatens the unity of the Republic. As battles rage across the galaxy, more worlds succumb to the seductive lure of the Separatists and leave the Republic. On a vital mission of peace, Senator Padme Amidala journeys to the outer rim world of Rodia, desperate to ensure its loyalty remains to the Republic. Viceroy Gunray captured. Senator Padme Amidala has scored a victory against the Separatist Alliance on the remote world of Rodia, securing the arrest of diabolical Confederate leader Newt Gunray. The Jedi Council has dispatched Master Luminara Unduli and Anakin Skywalker's Padawan Ahsoka to escort the Viceroy to Coruscant under heavy guard. Once there, he will face trial for his many war crimes. Viceroy Gunray escapes. En route to Coruscant to stand trial for war crimes, evil Separatist leader Newt Gunray has broken free of his Jedi escort. With the help of Count Dooku's sinister agents, the villainous Viceroy has made a daring getaway. Alerted to the bold prison break, Jedi Master Kit Fisto has traced the stolen ship to a remote system, hoping to recapture Gunray and return him to justice. Manhunt. After a long and perilous search, the Jedi finally track down Separatist leader Count Dooku. During a heroic attempt to capture the Count, Anakin Skywalker has gone missing. Having lost contact with Skywalker, Obi-Wan Kenobi heads toward his friend's last known location, a lone Separatist frigate in the far reaches of the Outer Rim. Dooku held for ransom. After escaping capture by Jedi Knights Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi, the villainous Count Dooku fell into the clutches of pirates led by the brigand Hondo Anaka. Eager to get custody of Dooku, the Republic agreed to pay Hondo a hefty sum in exchange for the Sith Lord. But Anakin and Obi-Wan had not counted on the treacherous cunning of Anaka and his band. The Republic fleet is on the defensive and pushed to the brink. As war rages in the much-contested Outer Rim territories, chaos and fear mount as the Separatist army rages an epic battle against heavily outnumbered Republic ships. In the far reaches of the Quell system, Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka race across the galaxy to aid Jedi Knight Aayla Secura, who is in the midst of a fight for her life as the sinister droid army closes in. Republic forces in retreat. While rescuing General Aayla Secura from certain defeat, Anakin Skywalker has been seriously injured. After a narrow escape, our heroes crash-landed on the remote world of Meridon. Stranded and with no way to contact the Republic, the Jedi receive medical aid from the peaceful Lerman colonists. But even on this tiny planet, the war threatens to follow the Jedi. Republic outpost overrun. The Jedi have lost all contact with a clone security force stationed on the bleak, snow-covered planet of Orto Plutonia. Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker, accompanied by dignitaries from the nearby moon of Pantora, are sent to investigate the disappearance of the clone troopers on the desolate and forbidding landscape. Battle droids on Naboo! As the Separatist Rebellion rages through the galaxy, even peaceful planets are threatened. Following the discovery of Separatist droids wandering the grassy wasteland, Naboo is once again on high alert. Fearing their home is facing another invasion, Senator Amidala and Representative Binks race to Naboo to assess the situation. Meanwhile, near the Gungan swamplands, an even graver threat is about to be discovered. Hard-pressed Jedi and their valiant clone troopers have thwarted an insidious Separatist plot to plant bombs loaded with the deadly blue shadow virus in key Republic systems. Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker have captured the vile scientist behind the nefarious scheme, Dr. Nuvo Vindi. Now the Jedi prepare to transport Vindi to the Republic capital for trial. Planet Ryloth invaded. Subjected to a brutal droid occupation, the people of Ryloth are starving under the blockade of a Separatist fleet. Evil Separatist leader Wat Tambor now rules with an iron fist. Answering a plea from the Senate, the Grand Army of the Republic mounts a bold offensive to liberate the system. It is up to Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka to make way for Obi-Wan's ground assault. Invasion. Separatist leader Wat Tambor has taken control of the planet Ryloth and subjugates its people through a brutal droid occupation. In a daring surprise attack, Jedi Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano defeated the space blockade guarding the planet. Now, Jedi Generals Mace Windu and Obi-Wan Kenobi lead a massive invasion to liberate the starving people. Republic victory is at hand. Clone troopers under the command of the Jedi have successfully invaded the Separatist-occupied world of Ryloth. Anakin Skywalker battles the enemies in the skies, while Obi-Wan Kenobi frees villages from the grip of vile Separatist leader Wat Tambor. Now Jedi General Mace Windu leads the attack on enemy lines in the final offensive to liberate the capital city of Lesu. Jedi trapped on Felucia. Clones are surrounded by droid forces. Their only hope is to escape on Republic gunships waiting to land on the embattled surface. Jedi cruisers have managed to blow a hole in the droid defenses and have sent gunships to the rescue. Stolen secrets. Villainous mercenary Cad Bane was hired by Darth Sidious to steal a holocron from the vaults of the Jedi Temple. After fleeing the scene of the crime, Bane hunted down and captured Master Bolo Ropal, who has a crystal which holds secrets of the Jedi Order. As a Separatist fleet arrives to help the bounty hunter, Anakin Skywalker races in to cut off their escape and stop Bane from delivering the stolen holocron. A thief hunted. In a daring assault, Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka boarded the warship of cunning bounty hunter Cad Bane to recover a stolen holocron containing a list of the galaxy's Force-sensitive children and future Jedi Knights. After a desperate chase and duel with the villain, Anakin and his troops defeated Bane, but were forced to evacuate his doomed vessel without the holocron. The death toll rises. As the battles intensify and threaten a growing number of Republic worlds, planets are left to survive on their own, while the Jedi struggle to fight a war on many fronts. A series of medical stations have been established as a lifeline for those in need. But the facilities are easy prey for Separatist attacks. After losing contact with the medical station orbiting Felucia, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin Skywalker, and Ahsoka Tano are sent to investigate. Desperate times call for desperate measures. In one of the longest and fiercest battles of the war, Separatist forces are on the verge of claiming the planet Malastare. If the Republic loses this planet, it will cost them vital fuel resources necessary for maintaining their armies. In a final effort to turn the tide of this battle, Supreme Chancellor Palpatine has authorized the use of the Republic's newest weapon, the Electro-Proton Bomb. Now at the Imperial Palace of Doge Urus, the leader of the Dugs, the Jedi count down the minutes until the detonation of their doomsday device. A calculated risk. Following a costly victory on the planet Malastare, Chancellor Palpatine orders Jedi Knights Mace Windu and Anakin Skywalker to transport a fearsome Zillo beast captured during the battle back to Coruscant. After seeing that not even a lightsaber could harm the beast, Chancellor Palpatine hopes to unlock the secret of its invulnerability to create new armor for the Republic's clone troopers. Tensions run high as the most dangerous life form in the galaxy touches down on the Republic's most populous planet. Treachery in the Senate. The Jedi Council suspects that Senator Rush Clovis is secretly taking part in a Separatist conspiracy. But to find out what the senator from Scipio is up to, the Council will need a spy of its own. Meanwhile, Jedi Anakin Skywalker has been away from Coruscant on a lengthy tour of duty leading the clone army. Now, Anakin returns for a long-awaited reunion with his wife, Padme Amidala. Counterattack! With the clone army stretched in a desperate attempt to engage General Grievous's Starfleet, Separatist planets that were once thought secure are now rising up against the Republic. On Geonosis, Separatist leader Pogo the Lesser, safe in his newly ray-shielded factories, creates thousands of terrible new weapons, which march off the assembly line against the outnumbered clone army. The Jedi, resolute in their effort to restore order to the Republic, mount a massive invasion to retake Geonosis and shut down Poggle's factories of terror once and for all. The final surge. having learned of Warlord Poggle the Lesser's plot to rebuild a separatist droid foundry on Geonosis, Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano prepare to assault this heavily fortified installation. Their mission, destroy the factory at all cost. Anticipating stiff resistance, Republic Commander send Jedi Master Luminara Unduli and her Padawan Barriss Offee to reinforce the attack. But time runs short for our intrepid heroes as the dreaded droid mill nears completion. Victory on Geonosis! After a massive planetary siege, the Separatist forces on Geonosis have finally fallen. Key weapons factories have been destroyed, but at a heavy cost to Republic troops. Now, as Jedi Master Luminara Unduli and Obi-Wan Kenobi begin a cleanup of the planet, they launch an intense campaign to find Separatist leader Poggle the Lesser and bring him to justice. Victory on Geonosis! After a massive assault, the Republic has finally recaptured the Separatist planet and shut down its droid factories of doom. An investigation by Luminara Unduli led to the discovery of Queen Karina the Great, whose hive mind could reanimate dead Geonosian soldiers. During the destruction of the Queen's Temple, the Jedi apprehended her advisor, Poggle the Lesser, and now prepare to deliver the villain to Coruscant for trial. Diabolical defeat. Though Republic victories outnumber their losses, the Jedi have been unable to stop Separatist advances in the Outer Rim. The ever-elusive General Grievous stays one step ahead of his opponents. With thousands of droid armies at his command, the Jedi can never predict where Grievous will strike next, until now. Fugitive! Though the Republic has won many decisive battles against the Separatist army in the Outer Rim, the Jedi have failed to capture the elusive General Grievous. After specifically targeting members of the Jedi Council, a trap was set. But following a fierce confrontation, the droid general managed to escape to the surface of the planet Seleucami. Now the chase is on as General Kenobi leads a squadron of clone troopers and closes in on his desperate target. War creates opportunities for the criminal underworld. Ruthless mercenaries conspire with the Separatists to disrupt and exploit the unstable situation within the Republic. Now, Anakin Skywalker and Ahsoka Tano descend into the treacherous gangster havens in an effort to find a corrupt and vile arms dealer who is buying weapons on the black market and selling them to the Republic's enemies. Diplomacy or deception? The Council of Neutral Systems speaks for over 1,500 worlds who want to stay out of the war. But rumors have reached the Republic Senate, suggesting that the Council's new leader, Duchess Satine of Mandalore, is secretly building her own army to fight for the Separatist cause. Now, Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi has been sent to Mandalore to discover the truth behind these claims. A royal welcome! Sent to investigate allegations that Mandalore was joining Count Dooku's Separatist, Obi-Wan Kenobi was reunited with an old friend, the Duchess Satine of Kalvala. While Satine claimed Mandalore's intentions were to remain neutral during the war, an attack on the capital city led Obi-Wan to the discovery of a terrorist organization known as Death Watch. Now the Duchess travels to the Senate so she can plead her case against her involvement in the war as the Jedi prepare a defense against her opponents. A diplomatic mission. As dissent threatens to tear apart the peaceful Mandalore system, Duchess Satine struggles to protect her people against the escalating violence. Betrayed by two of her trusted allies, Satine now travels to Coruscant. There, she hopes to convince the Senate that a destructive splinter group, Death Watch, does not represent the entire Mandalorian government. Calm before the storm. A rare and welcome respite from endless battle awaits Jedi Knights Anakin Skywalker and Mace Windu as they travel through deep space aboard the Jedi cruiser Endurance. Preparing to rendezvous with a Republic frigate, the Jedi remain unaware of a deadly peril lying hidden in their midst. Revenge. Boba Fett, son of the notorious bounty hunter Jango Fett, infiltrated a Jedi cruiser in an attempt to assassinate General Mace Windu, the man who killed his father. After a near miss at Windu's quarters, Boba was forced to destroy the Jedi cruiser and escape with the help of notorious bounty hunter Aura Singh. Now, having lost contact with Admiral Killian when his doomed starship crashed, the Jedi search for survivors with the aid of a Republic rescue ship. lethal track down. The young Boba Fett has taken the law into his own hands and made two attempts on the life of Mace Windu, the Jedi Master who killed his father. Boba's mentor, bounty hunter Aura Singh, has taken three Republic officers hostage in an effort to force Windu to face Boba on their terms. A tactic that does not sit well with the young vigilante. Desperate times on Mandalore. Having won neutrality for the Mandalorian system, Duchess Satine now finds herself an outsider with little aid to her people. Supplies are impossible to come by except on the black market. As a result, the Duchess faces a world consumed by greed. Hoping to alleviate some of the tensions rising in the capital city of Sundari, Satine has called upon her friend Padme Amidala to make a diplomatic visit. A world in crisis. The peaceful planet of Mandalore is being strangled by the grip of corruption. With shortages of every kind, citizens must turn to the black market in order to survive. Desperate to free her people, Duchess Satine has asked her friend Padme Amidala to speak with the Jedi Council in hopes that they will send assistance to her struggling world. Criminals captured. Jedi Master Plo Koon and Padawan Ahsoka Tano successfully thwarted an attempt on Mace Windu's life, killing bounty hunter Aura Singh in the process. Since that time, young Ahsoka has grown strong in the ways of the Force. Now, after several harrowing adventures alongside her master, the two Jedi have returned to the temple on Coruscant to receive their next mission. Separatist attack! After the destruction of the Republic outpost on the Rishi Moon, General Grievous and Asajj Ventress plan an attack on the planet Kamino, home of the cloning factories. Meanwhile, aboard a Jedi cruiser, Jedi Knights Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi examine an intercepted message from General Grievous. Pantora in peril! The newly elected chairman of Pantora, Baron Papanoida, is caught in a deadly political game. The Trade Federation has blockaded Pantora and suspended all commerce with the system. Isolated from the rest of the Republic, the people of Pantora are beginning to rally against the Senate, who have seemed unsympathetic to their plight. To make matters worse, Count Dooku has come forward offering aid if Pantora joins the Separatist Alliance. Chairman Papanoida has dispatched Senator Chuchi to Coruscant with the hope that she can motivate the Senate to act in favor of Pantora before Lot Dodd can legitimize the blockade. Evil plans! With the Jedi Council focused on the war effort, criminal minds are left unchecked to spread fear and corruption. Galactic gangster Jabba the Hutt has sent bounty hunter Cad Bane on a nefarious mission, which shall strike at the heart of the Republic. Meanwhile, the unsuspecting citizens of Coruscant go about their daily lives. Danger looms! Despite recent victories in the Outer Rim, criminal minds plot at the very heart of the Republic. The bounty hunter Cad Bane has assembled some of the deadliest criminals in the galaxy and plans a daring attack to seize members of the Senate. What could be the aim of this despicable act? A great escape! Cad Bane and his notorious crew of bounty hunters liberated Zero the Hutt from a Republic prison after holding the Galactic Senate hostage. The Jedi Council has assigned Obi-Wan Kenobi to retrieve Zero the Hutt with the help of Jedi Knight Quinlan Vos. Unknown to the Jedi, we find Zero in the clutches of the five Hutt families on the distant world of Naal Hutta. Conflict with no end in sight. Across the galaxy, the quagmire of war continues. While clone troopers suffer casualties at alarming rates, the Galactic Senate convenes an emergency session to debate the true cost of the war. Peace shattered. Once promising negotiations between the Republic and the Separatists are now in shambles following a droid suicide bombing on the capital city planet of Coruscant. As fear and anger prevail, the Senate overwhelmingly passes a bill to deregulate the banks, opening the gateway to additional troops and an increase in fighting. War on many fronts. While battles are fought by clones in the field, a different war is waged in the Galactic Senate. As heavy losses add up, a group of senators led by Halle Bertoni of Kamino propose an escalation of troop production. Senator Padme Amidala, recognizing that more troops will only prolong the fighting, works tirelessly with her allies to introduce a bill to cut military spending and stop the creation of more clone troopers. Galactic Showdown. In a fierce battle for survival, the Republic and Separatist armies have clashed in the distant solar system. Count Dooku's most cunning assassin, Asajj Ventress, leads the vicious attack. A bid for revenge. Betrayed and left for dead by Count Dooku, Asajj Ventress has begun a deadly game with her former master, launching a secret assassination attempt against him with the help of her kin, the mysterious Night Sisters. Deceived into believing the Jedi are behind the recent attack, Dooku has traveled across the galaxy to enlist the Night Sisters in his quest for vengeance. Mysterious deaths. Unknown to the Jedi, a new threat has been unleashed on the galaxy. Savage Opress, a pawn in the dangerous game between Count Dooku and his former assassin Ventress. The victims of his brutal massacre on the planet of Devaron are being returned to the Jedi Temple for evaluation. It's up to the Jedi Council to find this mysterious killer and eradicate him. Mysterious message. A transmission has been intercepted far beyond the Outer Rim, deep in the Krillithium system. Why the call has been made and from where cannot be established. But buried in the message is a Jedi distress code that has not been used in over 2,000 years. Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin Skywalker, and his Padawan Ahsoka are sent to investigate. Fearing a Separatist trap, they are to meet with a heavily armed Jedi cruiser. Mystery on Mortis. Sent to discover the origin of a mysterious distress call, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin Skywalker, and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano are stranded on a distant planet. There they discover three beings more powerful with the Force than any Jedi have seen before. The father keeps a fragile balance between his daughter, who allies with the light side, and the son, who drifts ever closer to the dark. With his strength failing, the father asks Anakin to stay and take his place, preserving the balance between light and dark. But after passing a perilous test, Skywalker refuses. Now we find our heroes about to depart for their journey home. Or so they think. Stranded! Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin Skywalker, and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano are caught in the middle of a treacherous battle between good and evil. The scales now tip toward the dark side. Our three warriors must guard against attack as they plan their escape. A great weight has been placed on Anakin's shoulders, for it is now that he must face who he really is. Captured! Returning from a perilous assignment in the Outer Rim, Jedi Master Evan Peel's cruiser has fallen under attack and been boarded. Seeking vital information he carries about secret hyperspace lanes called the Nexus Route, Separatist forces have taken him alive. Now the Jedi are preparing a stealth mission into the heart of Separatist space in an effort to rescue Master Peel from the deadly prison known as the Citadel. Escape from a Separatist prison! Carrying information about secret routes into the heart of the Republic and Separatist homeworlds, Jedi Master Evan Peel was captured and imprisoned in a fortress known as the Citadel. Leading an elite strike team, Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker rescued Master Peel and his officers. Now the Jedi have split up to evade Separatist forces as they attempt to escape the Citadel. Trapped behind enemy lines, carrying secret information vital to the Republic's war effort, Jedi Master Evan Peel and Captain Tarkin were taken prisoner by the Separatists. An elite strike team led by Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker landed on the planet Lola Seu and infiltrated the prison. The team rescued Master Peel and Tarkin, but they were pursued by the prison's evil commandant Osei Sobek. During the escape, their ship was destroyed. Now we find them on the run, desperate to escape the trap that is the Citadel. Turmoil in the Outer Rim. Located near a major hyperspace lane, the planet Felucia is caught in an unending battle between Republic and Separatist forces. Clone tank divisions make a valiant push deep into Separatist-controlled territory, led by Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano. General Grievous, learning of the impending Jedi attack, has dispatched reinforcements to one of his droid outposts, hoping to secure his grip on the system. Jedi abducted! Ahsoka Tano is missing in action. Captured and released into a hostile jungle, she fights to stay alive with the help of a small band of Jedi younglings. As Anakin Skywalker scours the galaxy, desperate to find his lost apprentice, Trandoshan sport hunters track their youngling prey. With the death of their leader, Khalifa, and separated from her friends, we find Ahsoka on the run as the hunters close in around her. Water Wars. Tensions run high on the ocean world of Mon Calamari, where two separate peoples, the aggressive squid-like Quarren and their peaceful neighbor, the Mon Calamari, struggle to maintain a fragile coexistence. Adding to this strife, the king of the Mon Calamari has been found mysteriously murdered, leaving his young son, Prince Lee Char, to guide his people alone. But the Quarren race will not accept the new ruler as their king. Senator Amidala and her Jedi bodyguard have arrived to help resolve the matter and to avoid plunging the planet into civil war. A government toppled by civil war. Refusing to accept Prince Lee Char as the next ruler of Mon Cala, the Quarren people join the Separatist Alliance and launch an all-out attack on the Mon Calamari. Caught unprepared, the young prince and his Jedi protectors are quickly overwhelmed and forced to retreat into caves far below the capital city, leaving Count Dooku and his allies to plan their next move. A last gasp of hope. After the assassination of his father and the fall of his kingdom beneath a planetary civil war, Mon Cala Prince Lee Char has gone into hiding with Padawan Ahsoka Tano as his only protector. With his armies captured and friends imprisoned, the situation seems hopeless for the prince. Count Dooku commands his sinister agent Riff Tamson to use any means necessary to bring Prince Lee Char out of hiding, for he knows that hope does remain as long as the prince is alive. As war continues to fracture the galaxy, planets become pawns in a dangerous chess game. One planet in peril is Naboo, where suffering and civil unrest threaten once friendly relations between the people on the surface and the underwater-dwelling Gungans. Rumors that the Gungans plan to aid the Separatists in an attack on Theed force Senator Padme Amidala home, accompanied by Jedi General Anakin Skywalker. Global Crisis. The mid-rim planet of Aleen is devastated by catastrophic earthquakes. As the people struggle, the future of the survivors rests on their ability to rekindle a way of life from the rubble of the past. A Jedi transport on a mission to block Separatist annexation of the Qui-Lura system is waylaid to provide desperately needed humanitarian relief to the people on the surface of Aleen. Homeward Bound. On a peaceful relief mission to the planet Aleen, R2-D2 and C-3PO were caught up in an adventure beyond their comprehension. After finally resolving the crisis and being taken to Jedi Master Adigalia's cruiser, they now head home toward the safety of the Republic, hoping to avoid a Separatist attack. War in the expansion region. As the Separatists tighten their grip over vital but isolated supply routes, the Republic launches a lightning strike into a remote ghost nebula to control the strategic system of Umbara. Republic forces smash through the Separatist blockade in an effort to claim the shadowy world. While fighting to control the darkened world of Umbara, Anakin Skywalker's battalion is temporarily placed under the command of Jedi General Pong Krell. As Krell's disastrous strategies result in increasing casualties, his men begin to turn against him. Captain Rex struggles to balance loyalty between his commander and his fellow men. Under his watch, Fives and Jesse disobey Krell's orders, resulting in their court-martial. Turning the Tide. As Separatist control over vital but isolated supply routes expands, Republic forces invade a key planet, the darkened world of Umbara. In the midst of helping Obi-Wan Kenobi's battalion conquer the Umbaran capital, Anakin Skywalker is called away to Coruscant. His battalion is temporarily placed under the command of Jedi General Pong Krell, a shrewd and temperamental leader. Krell's reckless strategy forced Captain Rex to retreat with his platoons in a disastrous defeat. Invasion in peril. Republic forces struggle to take Umbara, a hostile planet completely enshrouded in darkness. Jedi General Pong Krell and Captain Rex lead a battalion against a constant attack by a brutal enemy. Krell's aggressive and reckless strategies backfire, killing many clones. Despite the Jedi General's dangerous tactics, Captain Rex's squad successfully captures a critical airbase. This further fuels the mistrust of Krell's leadership, dividing his men. A planet of peace. The artisan colony of the planet Kyros created a society without weapons. Instead of war, they pursued art and beauty. But in the Clone Wars, even peace-loving worlds are seemingly forced to change sides. Kidnapped! During a separatist invasion of the planet Kyros, thousands of peaceful colonists were abducted by Zygarian slavers. Determined to find the missing colonists, the Jedi traveled to Zygaria, home to the galaxy's most notorious slave empire. A people enslaved! To locate the abducted colonists of a peace-loving world, the Jedi infiltrated the slaver planet of Zygaria, only to be captured by its ambitious queen, who plots to rebuild her empire of oppression. Now, even Obi-Wan Kenobi must come to terms with a life in chains. Divided by war. In an effort to end the galactic conflict, the first ever sanctioned meeting between the Republic and the Separatists will be held, and Mandalore is chosen as neutral ground for these precarious meetings. Tensions run high as many hold hope for these important negotiations. A terrorist threat. Morallo Eball, mastermind of a separatist plot to kidnap Chancellor Palpatine, has been captured by Republic forces. But even with the criminal behind bars, rumors swirl in the underworld of Coruscant that Morallo's plot has already been set in motion. With precious time running out, the Jedi Council hatches their own plot to keep the Chancellor safe. Fugitives on the run. Disguised as Jedi killer Reiko Hardeen, Obi-Wan Kenobi works undercover to solve a separatist plot against Chancellor Palpatine. Obi-Wan meets the plot's mastermind, Morallo Eball, breaking him out of jail to gain his trust. But now Kenobi faces another obstacle, bounty hunter Cad Bane. Can Obi-Wan Kenobi overcome Bane's suspicions? Or will the ruthless criminal see through his disguise and expose the Jedi? Only time will tell. Obi-Wan Kenobi in disguise. Working undercover as assassin Reiko Hardeen, Obi-Wan leads a secret mission to uncover the separatist plot against Chancellor Palpatine. Using cunning and courage, he gains the trust of bounty hunter Cad Bane and criminal mastermind Morallo Eball, earning him entrance to the stronghold of separatist leader Count Dooku. Now it is here, on the beautiful planet of Sereno, that a barbaric contest will determine the fate of Obi-Wan Kenobi, and possibly the Republic itself. Supreme Chancellor in peril. After surviving the ordeals of the box, Obi-Wan Kenobi, working undercover as assassin Reiko Hardeen, is invited to join Count Dooku's plot against Chancellor Palpatine. Working with a team of deadly bounty hunters, Obi-Wan travels to the planet of Naboo, where the Chancellor will preside over the Festival of Light. Now, as the Jedi Council and Count Dooku finalize their respective plans, a deadly confrontation seems inevitable. Sinister forces on the move. Asajj Ventress has suffered a humiliating betrayal at the hands of her own assassin, Savage Opress. Having gone into hiding, she now has no choice but to seek sanctuary with the Night Sisters of Dathomir. Abandoned. After an assassination attempt by his forsaken apprentice, Asajj Ventress, Count Dooku launches a brutal counterattack against the Night Sisters, massacring the entire clan. Forced into exile, Ventress wanders far into the Outer Rim among the castaways and vagabonds of the galaxy, seeking her new life that was foretold by Mother Talzin. A darkness awakes. Count Dooku's bitter betrayal of his former apprentice, Asajj Ventress, resulted in the creation of a new menace in the galaxy, Savage Opress. Caught in a deadly game of revenge between Ventress and Dooku, Savage barely escaped the carnage. Beaten and alone, he returned to Mother Talzin, his creator, who gave him a new quest to pursue his long-lost brother. Brothers reunited! Darth Maul, the sinister Sith, thought to have been destroyed so many years ago by Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi, was found alive by his brother, Savage Opress, and taken back to Mother Talzin on Dathomir. Though Darth Maul's memory has yet to be fully restored, his need for vengeance has awakened, more powerful than ever. Separatist takeover complete! Another Republic planet has fallen! Onderon has seceded to the Confederacy of Independent Systems under the rule of a new king. However, a small band of rebels have taken refuge deep within its vast and savage wilderness. From an abandoned outpost, they plot to take back the heavily fortified capital city of Isis and end the separatist occupation. Jedi Fallen Rebel Alliance. Led by Anakin Skywalker, the Jedi have trained a band of rebels to fight the separatists on the planet Onderon. With the help of the Jedi, the rebels escape capture and infiltrated the heavily fortified city of Isis. Now our heroes have launched an armed campaign to subvert the separatist occupation of the planet. The Jedi Council continue to observe and advise as the rebels strive to gain momentum against the separatist forces. Despite the absence of civilian casualties, public fear has ensued as reports of the rebels' daring strikes circulate throughout the city. The rebels elect a new leader. With their training complete, Obi-Wan and Anakin have left Ahsoka on Onderon to monitor and advise the rebels as they continue to strike separatist targets under the command of Steela Guerrera. Facing an escalation of rebel attacks, the separatists have sent reinforcements to strengthen their hold on the city of Isis as the battle for the planet unfolds. War in the Inner Rim. Rebel leader Steela Guerrera has joined forces with General Tandon after boldly rescuing Onderon's former king from execution, evading a trap set by separatist ally King Rash and the droid General Kalani. Amid growing public support and rising unrest, Ahsoka continues to monitor the rebels' efforts as they rally around Ramses Dendup to restore his reign as the rightful king and finally put an end to the separatist occupation of Onderon. As the Clone Wars scorches its destructive path across the galaxy, it is the Jedi who bring order to the chaos. Though as the war progresses, the number of Jedi have declined and new younglings are harder to find. When a youngling is located, they are brought to the Jedi Temple and learn quickly that their true family is now the Jedi Order. The trials are hard, tests must be passed, but none is as important as the gathering. It is then that a Jedi's path will truly begin. Ancient Jedi tradition. 6 younglings are sent to the secret caverns of Ilum, where they are tested by the gathering. An ancient Jedi ritual where each youngling must harvest a crystal around which they will construct their own lightsaber. Along the journey, they underwent great perils, hardest of which was to face themselves. Now, having passed the test, they take their first step into a larger world. Piracy in deep space. Infamous outlaw Hondo Ohnaka attacks a Jedi transport carrying 6 younglings who just received their lightsaber crystals. So rare are these crystals that Hondo knows he can sell them on the black market for a small fortune. In a desperate attempt to save the younglings, Ahsoka Tano is captured by Hondo and his pirate horde. Now, with a damaged ship, the younglings are stranded and alone. Pursued by pirates. While on a rite of passage, 6 Jedi younglings and Ahsoka Tano are ambushed. Protecting the young Jedi, Ahsoka was captured by the nefarious Hondo Ohnaka and taken to the planet Florum. Marshaling their courage and training, the younglings infiltrated the pirate stronghold and rescued Ahsoka. Now we find our heroes in a race to their starship, with the pirates closing in. Secret transmission intercepted. The Jedi Council has intercepted an encoded transmission of General Grievous. However, Republic intelligence officers have failed to crack the new encryption code being used by the droids. Fears escalate that the separatists are about to mount a major offensive. Having located the source of the transmission deep in separatist space, the Jedi plan a counterstrike to capture an enemy decoding chip, which will allow them to understand the transmission and thwart the separatist plot. Secret weapons! The Jedi Council deploys a squad of droids on a desperate mission aboard a separatist cruiser. Under the guidance of Colonel Meeber Gascon, the droids succeed in stealing a crucial encryption module. Now the Colonel and his droid squad must return the module to the Jedi Temple to crack a separatist code detailing an impending terror plot against the Republic. Stranded on a secret mission for the Republic, Colonel Gascon and his intrepid droid squad successfully steal an encryption module from a separatist ship. During their escape, our heroes crash on the outer rim planet of Abafar and find themselves stranded in the strange wasteland called the Void. Now, after surviving against all odds, our heroes must find a way home and deliver the encryption module to crack the Separatist code and stop an enemy attack. Mission accomplished. Colonel Gascon and his droid squad steal an encryption module needed to crack a Separatist code and stop an impending attack on the Republic. After surviving the Void and escaping the hostile planet of Abafar, our heroes finally appear to be headed in the right direction. Death and destruction. Darth Maul and Savage Opress spread chaos as they descend on the Outer Rim. After rescuing his brother from despair, Savage and Maul murder and pillage at every turn. Fueled by rage and vengeance, they search for meaning in their new alliance as reports of their brutal attacks spread across the galaxy. Evil Alliance! Darth Maul and Savage Opress escape Obi-Wan Kenobi's assault once again. With their plan to build a crime organization in peril, the brothers' fate is about to be changed forever as they drift, barely alive, through unknown space. Villainy swells. With an army of the galaxy's most vicious criminals, Darth Maul and Savage Opress conspire with Pre Vizsla and the Death Watch to topple Duchess Satine, ruler of Mandalore. While the conspirators prepare to attack the Mandalorian capital of Sundari from a base on Zanbar, the fate of 2,000 other neutral systems is under threat as Darth Maul moves closer to establishing a vast criminal empire.
Where are my targets?
We've identified them.
Neutral star systems in peril. Darth Maul and Savage Opress command the planet Mandalore through the puppet Prime Minister Almec while they expand their criminal enterprise. With the Death Watch removed from power and the Jedi unaware of the villainous plot, nothing stands in the way of Darth Maul's vision for a vast criminal empire. We now find Duchess Satine imprisoned as her few remaining loyal subjects make a desperate attempt to rescue her. Invasion! The planet Cato Nemoidia is under Separatist attack. Anakin Skywalker and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano rush to the rescue as they lead a squadron of starfighters to the planet below. Terror at the Temple! The Jedi Temple is in disarray after a vicious terrorist attack. Anakin Skywalker and Ahsoka Tano set out to find the truth of who was really behind this horrendous catastrophe. Their investigation led them to discover the true saboteur, Leta Termond. Now the Jedi attempt to return the temple to normalcy. But first, Master Yoda must give a eulogy to the fallen Jedi warriors. Ahsoka Tano on the run! After an attack on the Jedi Temple, Anakin Skywalker's young Padawan found herself accused of murdering the person responsible for the bombings. With no choice but to run, she was chased by her master, who begged her to turn herself in. Knowing there is little hope of being cleared of the crimes, Ahsoka decided to find out the truth and prove her innocence on her own. Ahsoka Tano captured! While on the run to prove her innocence, Padawan Tano teamed up with the deadly Asajj Ventress to find the rogue Jedi who framed Ahsoka for murder. The Jedi Council sent Anakin Skywalker and Master Plo Koon to track Ahsoka down and bring her back to the temple. Now captured and imprisoned, Ahsoka faces punishment for crimes she did not commit. Battle for Ringo Vinda. Republic forces are locked in heated combat with the droid armada on a massive space station that encircles an entire planet. Anakin Skywalker valiantly leads his men against the onslaught, which has lasted several rotations with neither side gaining any ground. Aided by the twin sister Jedi Masters Tipley and Tiplar, the Republic now mounts a desperate offensive to break the deadlock. A flaw in the plan. While in the middle of a heated battle, clone trooper Tup lost his senses and killed a Jedi general. Seeming to have no awareness of his actions, Tup's health began to deteriorate rapidly. Fearing the illness was linked to a Separatist plot, Anakin Skywalker has dispatched Captain Rex and ARC Trooper 5555 to escort Tuck back to the cloning facilities on Kamino for an intensive evaluation. Cause of death unknown. Kamino and Dr. Nola Say was unable to find the cause of an illness in Clone Trooper Tup. In a desperate attempt to save his friend's life, Fives located and removed a tumor from Tup's brain with the help of medical droid AZ-3. Immediately following the procedure, Tup died, and Fives was placed under arrest. Now the tumor is the only hope to finding answers for Tup's mysterious illness. Clone Crisis. After the mysterious death of his friend Tup, ARC Trooper Fives embarked on an investigation which led to the discovery of a hidden chip which is placed inside clone troopers when they are still embryos. The Kaminoan scientist Nala Say claims the chip is harmless and is meant to restrain the clones from violent, unpredictable action. Fives claims otherwise and has convinced Jedi Master Shaak Ti to allow him to plead his case directly to Supreme Chancellor Palpatine on Coruscant. As the war between the Republic and the Separatists intensifies, many are driven from their home planets, and it is up to Senator Amidala to secure aid for them. All eyes turn to the Banking Clan and the planet Scipio. In an effort to remain independent from the Republic and the Separatists, all operations are divided, and money transactions are performed in a neutral zone surrounding the main vault. For operations to continue, there must be no war on Scipio. However, worry about the stability of the Banking Clan is brewing within the Republic, as the wellspring of money may be in jeopardy. War Profiteers. In time of war, credits are the fuel that fund all operations. Senator Amidala is sent to Scipio to resolve matters between the Republic and the Intergalactic Banking Clan. Here she is reunited with Rush Clovis, a once close friend, but now a known traitor to the Republic. When Clovis reveals corruption at the core of the Banking Clan, Senator Amidala helps him steal vital files that may uncover the full extent of the plot. Anakin Skywalker is sent to rescue the Senator and escort the information back to Coruscant, leaving the Banking Clan in chaos. Corruption discovered at the core of the Banking Clan. Reunited, Rush Clovis and Senator Amidala discover the full extent of the deception. Anakin Skywalker is sent to the rescue. He refuses to trust Clovis and asks Padme not to work with him. Determined to save the banks, she refuses her husband's request, throwing their relationship into turmoil. Voted for by both the Separatists and the Republic, Rush Clovis is elected new leader of the Galactic Banking Clan. Now all attention is focused on Scipio as the important transfer of power begins. Mystery on Bardotta, an oasis of peace during the Clone Wars. The galaxy-wide conflict now threatens the ancient ways of the Bardotan people. With their spiritual leaders mysteriously vanishing, the foundations of order in its system are near collapse. In desperation, the Queen of Bardotta has called upon the Republic Senate with a puzzling request to help save her people from certain doom. Lost! Queen Julia of the planet Bardotta has been abducted. If Representative Jar Jar Binks and Jedi Master Mace Windu cannot find the missing queen in three rotations, a sinister prophecy will be fulfilled. The bloodthirsty Frangal cult will take over the Bardotan government, and its planetary system will be overwhelmed by chaos, death, and destruction. A long-awaited truth. A distress signal has been received at the Jedi Temple, and Master Plo Koon has been dispatched to investigate its origin. The signal is from a ship thought to be lost and was last known to be in the possession of a Jedi Master who was killed long ago. Jedi Mystery. A lightsaber was found on the moon of Obadiah. Belonging to Sifo Dyas, the Jedi responsible for the creation of the Clone Army. The Jedi have learned that before the start of the war, Count Dooku murdered Sifo Dyas and skillfully manipulated the Republic into the galactic conflict, intending for the Jedi to fight with the clones at their side. Now, as the Jedi Council meets to discuss the purpose of this deception, Master Yoda meditates deep into the Force in search of answers. Blinded by the dark side, the Jedi Council has begun to unravel the mystery of how the Clone Army was created And now fear the Sith Lord Count Dooku was behind it. Master Yoda searches for answers, and during deep meditation, he is able to contact the spirit of Qui-Gon Jinn, who reveals to Yoda that he must manifest his consciousness after death if he is to preserve the Jedi Order. Now we find Master Yoda deep in space, searching for a path to ones who will teach him all he does not know of the Force. Darkness on Dagobah. All attention is focused on Yoda, who claims to hear the voice of a long-dead Jedi. Convinced that he is guided by Qui-Gon Jinn, he finds five priestesses who will teach him how to manifest consciousness after death. After many trials, Yoda travels to Moraban, ancient home planet of the Sith. For now, he must face the true evil that may be his undoing, and one that seeks to control the galaxy. Betrayal. Jedi Padawan Ahsoka Tano was wrongly accused of treason by the Jedi Council and hunted by the Grand Army of the Republic. Believing his apprentice was innocent, Anakin Skywalker discovered the true villain was Ahsoka's close friend, Barriss Offee. Unable to reconcile her relationship with the Jedi Order, Ahsoka decided to walk away from the only life she had ever known. Crossroads. After leaving the Jedi Order, Ahsoka Tano finds herself far away from the life she once knew. Here in the underworld of Coruscant, she meets Trace Martez, an aspiring pilot, and her older sister Rafa, a streetwise gambler with lofty aspirations. In their short time together, Ahsoka realizes not everyone sees the Jedi as heroes, a lesson she only recently learned herself. Prisoners of the Pikes. Ahsoka Tano has teamed up with the Martez sisters, who live in the underworld of the city planet Coruscant. Struggling to make ends meet, Rafa Martez scored a job running a spice shipment from the planet Kessel. Tempers flared when Ahsoka realized the spice was being sold to the Pikes, a powerful crime syndicate. As Ahsoka and Rafa argued, Trace Martez dumped the spice, hoping to end the dispute. With no shipment to deliver, the three attempted to deceive the Pikes and failed. We now find them imprisoned deep within a fortress on the planet Obadiah. Prisoners in peril. Former Jedi apprentice Ahsoka Tano befriended two sisters, Trace and Rafa Martez, who grew up in the underworld of Coruscant. After learning that the sisters blamed the Jedi Knights for the death of their parents, Ahsoka must decide if she's willing to reveal her Jedi past and use her skills to aid in their escape. Fearing her new friends will feel betrayed by this revelation, Ahsoka is left with a difficult choice. The battle for Anaxes. One of the Republic's largest shipyards is under attack from Admiral Trench's Separatist forces. Jedi Generals Mace Windu and Anakin Skywalker lead a two-pronged assault on the ground and in the air. But after weeks of heated battle and mounting losses, the Republic's grip on Anaxes begins to slip away. Conspiracy. After repeated setbacks on the planet Anaxes, an elite clone squad is deployed to investigate the Separatist tactical advantage. This special unit, called the Bad Batch, infiltrates Admiral Trench's cyber center to steal a strategic algorithm capable of predicting the Republic's every move. What our heroes found was a live signal from the ARC trooper known as Echo, a clone long believed to be dead. Trapped on an unsanctioned mission to rescue ARC trooper Echo, General Skywalker, Captain Rex, and the Bad Batch travel to Skako Minor, headquarters of the Techno Union. After a harrowing encounter with the natives, our heroes infiltrate the city of Burkhold, only to find themselves surrounded by Wat Tambor's forces. Reunited! With the help of the Bad Batch, Captain Rex rescues his old friend ARC Trooper Echo from the Techno Union. The Separatist loss of Echo's strategic algorithm provides a chance for the Republic to turn the tide in the battle for Anaxes. However, Echo's horrifying experience behind enemy lines leaves lingering questions of his true loyalty and uncertain future. Outer Rim, under siege. Separatist forces have launched a major offensive. Led by the evil droid General Grievous, Republic forces are pushed to the brink. In response to this overwhelming attack, the Jedi Council has dispatched its generals, sending them far from the core worlds to bolster the beleaguered clones. On the distant planet of Yavanna, we find Commander Cody of the 212th in desperate need of reinforcements.